Hi, everybody, it's Crazy, and for another week, this is episode 10, yay, of my learned video, or learned experience. Okay, so, this past week, I was getting more and more into, the chapters in the book I'm following along in, which is this book right here, called Adventure on Computer Games with Python, and I'm not gonna tell you where I got it. Not gonna tell you. So, if you want to know, check my other video. It's in the description below, or you can just go to my channel and, yeah, hit number 9, or number 8, or number 7. But they will definitely point you to, yes, I'm still not saying it. Okay? So, this book is, only reason why I chose this one is because it was. Create your own computer games with Python. So I was like, you know what? I am getting into gaming, building games. So I want to learn the gaming aspect of it. There's different varieties of things you can do with Python, and people are like, well, Python is a great language. Yes, it is. It's a great learning language, and a lot of people do simulations with it. A lot of people do, math with it. A lot of people do all kinds of cool stuff with, with Python. And you could do it with just about any programming language, but the one I'm wanting to do is Python because it's more comfortable for me. And since I'm trying to build a game, boop, yeah, there. Okay, I'm gonna do it with Adventure on Computer Games. So, with that being said, let me go to the chapter I am on. Let me bring that number up here. Okay, and that was here. And if you notice, I have a blue screen. Okay, now this blue screen is actually a little bit more helpful towards my eyes. I don't know if it's blind you're like, oh, it's blue. I tried yellow and that was pretty bad too. You want to go with more pastel colors. If you want to use any color, you would use yellow, blue, or red to kind of help you absorb what you're eating. And with that, you want to have it pastel. You don't want like neon yellow or bright blue or, oh my God, blinding red. So I did it. Okay, so I went ahead and did blue, and it actually helped. It helped my eyes not get so tired. If you're looking at a white screen for a long period of time, it does hurt your eyes. So with that, I went ahead and changed mine to blue. So as you see, yay, look at all the blue. It's nice and okay. So I am at this right now, which is chapter 16, and actually I'm further past that. I actually went to 18. I mean I've been kind of cramming it in there this week. but I started off with 16. It was one of the ones I was like, okay, AI. I don't know if I want to do AI at first. And then I was like, oh, I want to make everything AI. because it is a neat concept. It's not, it the computer being smarter, it's just giving it, directions to go. It's like steering a remote control car. If you push forward on the joystick, it's going to go forward. If you pull backward on a joystick, it's going to stop. So you're actually controlling it, but you're giving it choices. Instead of pushing up and down on the thing, you put little rotors on it and it does it randomly. So the car does circles and squares and, kind of stuff like that. So you're basically just telling it, the same thing you're doing with programming is what to do. Now, with that, I sat there and I was reading on it and it really gained my attention when I got to, hang on, I'm almost there. When it got to this right here, random shuffle. What? Okay, so it shuffles it around? Well, the more I read about it, I was sitting there going, oh, so what it's doing is it's taking the two moves that I have, which is right here, is it's going for the corner and it's going to find the highest score possible. So it's going to shuffle them around. Okay, it's going to say, okay, we're gonna do this one, and then we'll do this one, and then the next time it's gonna not do either one of them. It's gonna do just one. So it's gonna shuffle it around so it's not so, predictable. And I didn't realize that that right there is a pretty strong deal. And it really made me want to learn more about AI. So as I proceeded through the chapter, the next one was the second part. If you okay, if you look up here, it looks exactly the same, but at the very top up here it says AI Sim 2. Okay, now this one is just it playing itself 250 times to see how well it can do against itself. So let's go back to one and we'll just quickly do that. I want to run it. Okay, if we hit run, okay, it plays a super quick game. Shows the board and everything, and it just goes straight through. So you don't see it actually play all these. You just see it pop through. Boom, it's done. So with that being said, it won 25 times out of, and O won 39 times. And of course, X lost to the computer. Well, X lost to itself. So playing itself, it kind of gets like almost halfway. It's a half and half, sometimes a little bit more on one side than the other. So I was like, okay, that'd be kind of cool. So I went through and let me bring up two again. And it tells you go ahead and run it 250 times. So as it runs 250 times, you can get the end of it and ta-da! So you got X wins 108 out of 137. So in this case, O won it. So O won 54% of the time, while X only won 43, and there were five ties. That's pretty cool, right? So it played itself, so it kind of gives you a basis on, which one's better. And technically, O was a little bit better on this run, out of 250 times. But if you look up here, you'll see that the each point system, how it changes. So, and that was that one. And then they say, okay, well, let's change it up again. Let's go ahead and scroll down here. We got, of course, is on corner. Okay. And then it's got get corner best move. Okay, so it gets the best move, and then it gets the worst move. And then you've got get a random move. Is it on the side? Get corner side best move. So that's one, two, three, four, five. That's five things that it can shuffle through and pick one. And use that one, and so it kind of gives it a choice. So that's the whole idea about AI, is that you're giving the program a choice, and it randomly picks one. It's like the dice game, you put 1 to 0 or 1 to 6, and it picks a random number between 1 and 6. It's not really choosing it; it's just running through and stopping at a certain point. Well, this is the same thing. It's running through each one of these and stopping at a certain point. See. Yep, so we're getting on about 8 minutes. I wanted to get a little bit further in this, but AI is kind of interesting, and I'm really like on board with it now. But like before, I was kind of like, oh, AI, no. Now I'm more like, hey, this is, seems kind of interesting. I would like to, dabble a little bit more in it. But I also have to get up to where I'm at now. Now, 17 was getting into pie game. And so I'm going to put that one up over here on the other deal. Here's 272 is where I stopped at on that one. Okay, which basically goes through the whole thing. I'm going to turn off that one so you can see. I actually rolled through the whole thing, and basically just did it. I mean, it was simple. And if I ran it, I could show you. Wrong one. Boop. All right, there we go. So if I run this one, it's gonna go, "Hey, hello world." That's it. That's all it does. Just right here. And I was sitting there like, "Okay, that's pretty neat." Well, over here, and it's just kind of funny because at first, I was thinking, okay, yeah, Pygame, you know, I know a little bit about Pygame. I know what it does. It puts it up on the screen and it flips it. But in this one, he's not talking about how it flips it. It doesn't really flip it at all. All it's doing is putting it up there and then you're white screening it and doing it again. In order to show what it does, you can comment this out, which in the book, he suggested that you do this, okay? And then if I hit run again, now everything is black, right? Oh, this is not the right one. Okay, I'm on the wrong one here. Okay, you can change the backgrounds, okay? Without a background, it's going to be black. I'm like so far ahead of myself. Okay, but changing colors in it, you know, I mean, see, yeah, I changed to lime once. They put lime in there. F5. Yeah, now you've got a green background. So, I mean, this is just to get you started on how, you know, to use Pygame. And I'm just gonna put that back in there and save it, you know, right back to normal. Yay! Okay. So, basically, it just gives you the ins and outs, how to draw a circle, how to draw a square, how to draw a rectangle, and how to blit it on the screen. And I'm so used to rotate.flip, you know, which I haven't gotten to yet. And it's like, okay, well, but then I realize, oh, crazy. You're starting at the very beginning of this. This is before you went through all these other tutorials that are later on in time. This is an older style. And I was like, okay, so with that, I progressed on through until I got to where I'm at right now, which is chapter 18. And if I scroll up, let's see, 280. 280, which, and I'm pretty close to the end. Let's see, that's what? I'm about 68 pages away from the end. Okay, so basically it goes into, you know, this one goes into animation, how to make it animate. So I'm gonna run it. Okay, and this is the one I was talking about. Everything is, you know, moving around as you see it on a white screen. So it's like, yay! You know, you can change it to whatever color you want. I even think I put light blue. Yes, I did. Okay, so instead of white, let's do it light blue. BLUE. Okay. I did spell it right. Okay. I have to make sure if I spelled it right. Okay, so, hey, look at that. It's got a nice blue background, right? But how do you know it puts this blue screen up every time, every iteration through it, okay, every tick, okay, of the game loop, and every time it goes through one loop, it puts everything on the screen and then it puts the blue screen after, and it does it again, and it keeps doing that, so it's like a flash screen, that little book that people used to draw on the corners and then make it roll, same thing, but it's hard to tell because of the fact that you're taking out the screen, right? So here was that what I was trying to do. If you pound, put comment that out and run it, now look what it does. It doesn't stop. So all the animations that you saw are seeing are still being put on the screen, but it's not having anything, you know, blocking it off. So it doesn't look like it's moving, but it is moving, but it's drawing each one as it goes across. And it's doing that behind the scenes because you're using the background. You're doing the background. And so as it's doing that, you don't see all that because it's putting that blue background on there every single time. Okay? Every time it draws, you know, each one of those shapes, one, you know, whatever steps to the next point, then it whites it out, and then it does it again, and then it whites it out. It keeps doing that and constantly for every single movement. And I was like, to be honest with you, I was kind of floored because I was like, how can it do that? You know, it shouldn't really do that, you know, because don't you flip the screen for the game? You know, and you have to flip it, you know, but this is just filling it. You're using a fill in the while loop. So basically, as it goes through this and says, okay, neither one of these are hit, so let's go to the next one. It puts a blue screen on the back, and then it runs through the boxes for one kitch of it, one, I'm gonna say one step. I'll say one step. Okay, so for one step, it goes all the way through it, then it updates the display right here. Okay, and for 0.02 seconds, it holds off. And then it goes back up to the loop again, and it says, okay, he didn't hit exit, okay, and then it draws that one. So it erases everything, basically. Okay, within that split second, it erases it, and then it draws them all back over one, or I believe it's, I have it set for 4 pixels. So for 4 pixels, it puts it at 4 pixels on the next spot, depending on which way it's moving. And it goes through that iteration again, and it keeps doing that. And I'm like, really? That I'm starting to get that now. Okay, so it's not redrawing it every time on the screen, and then, taking it off and then putting it back up again. It's not flipping it. It's actually going through each one. And it says, okay, put everything on the screen, white it out. Put everything on the screen, white it out. Put everything on the screen, white it out. So basically, it's just flashing. If I took and commented all this out, you'd just see a light blue screen, right? Yeah, because it would iterate that every single time. So if I changed it from white to blue, and then I just changed these colors, and I did like, okay, let's do. I'm gonna do this because I it's one of those things. It's like I'm just curious. It back to white. Okay. We hit F5. So you don't see the blue. Why don't you? Because it's going so fast. Okay. That's why you don't see it. Because it's doing blue, and then it's doing white right over it. And then it's doing all this. And then it's doing this again, and then it's going over this. And it's constantly doing it. So I'm gonna comment that out. Because I do want to put it back to white, because that's why I had it. Okay. But if you notice, it wasn't a true white. Right? Hang on. That's not a true white. It's actually got kind of like a blue. Or is it just my eyes? I don't know. But okay. I'm getting a little far here. See, yeah, we're going on 17 minutes. So with that, I'm gonna leave it at that. So now I've gotten on the Pi game. It's the older version of Pi game. It's not too Pi game 2.0, which I'm actually familiar with. But it does trigger my memory, and I'm going, that makes some sense. Things are starting to actually sink in. So if you're following along with me and you've got the books, put in the comments what you think. Jump on my Discord server. It's all in the link below. And let me know what you think. Jump in and say hi, or just let me know in the comments. Okay? Until that time, see you next trip.